Everyone, it's Road to Retire, channel where I try to retire early with the help of doing various side hustles. And I talk about those side hustles on this channel. If you're interested, follow along and subscribe. OneForma, I finally got some project work on here. And this one is, sorry for the blacked out bar. It's just, I want to protect any NDAs. Don't want to give out any project names here or whatever. But this is a large language model project that I'm working on. Very similar to like a DAT, data annotation.tech, where you would work with chatbots and do various projects there. This is essentially the same thing, just not directly related to chatbots, but in the same realm. So I'm gonna draw a lot of comparisons. If you haven't worked on DAT, don't worry. I will give you a complete synopsis of my experience so far. So this technically isn't the main project. However, let me reword this. So right now the 9 tasks that I do were part of the, like, I guess you could say qualification, but I actually got the certifications already for it. They gave me an email saying, hey, you're good. Watch this training video and then do 10 tasks and then we will grade it, give you individualized feedback, and you will go from there. Now, I don't know why I'm not able to do 10. I'm pretty sure I did. It only says I did 9. No, I don't have any tasks available to work on. But essentially, this isn't like DAT where you're given like a set core test or qualification test or a starter assessment that pretty much everyone gets the same questions. The hits that I did here on the project on OneForma were the actual project tasks themselves. So what you would be working on if you passed this initial grading, I worked on here, and they pay you for taking these you are paid for your work for these qualifications, this initial grading period, which is something that data annotation.tech does not do. So I am very grateful for that. So this project was, again, I can't give away that much information about it, but basically you are trying to just make search results better. That's all I'm going to say without giving too much away. So how did I like my experience? The interface itself was fine. I had no issues manipulating the website at all to get results that I wanted. The actual task and the project inside the task itself was getting a little bit annoying, not gonna lie, trying to line up certain things. Again, it's hard for me to explain everything without going into details and risking any NDAs out there in terms of service, whatever you wanna call it. I will say that I'm very appreciative that this qualification test is paid, and I'm wondering if once I got onto the project, if I am, because these were more difficult, I'll get into that later, but if I pass this initial assessment, I guess you want to call it, and they give me good feedback and I'm able to continue the project long term, I'm wondering if these problems kind of get documented a little bit better and you get more consistent work where you're not constantly skipping tasks to get a correct filling out of the specific hit that you're working on. Because I probably had to skip around 10 to get these 9 completed hits that it's showing up on here because I couldn't get the functionality to properly work. So this is, at least on the projects I've worked on data annotation.tech, this project work was a little more challenging, required a little more thought, a little more effort. I think DAT, data annotation.tech, honestly is easy. If you're fluent in English and you have decent grammar, and even if you don't, you can use spell check and Grammarly or whatever on the platform. I think DAT is easy, honestly. This was a little more challenging. It wasn't as annoying or irritating as Appen's qualification test, that like 5-hour test that you take to just get paid $12 an hour for stupid rating. Now, I know that a lot of people say that's easier and whatever once you pass the test. Nonetheless, this project, if I'm able to get long-term work, pays anywhere from $20 to $25 an hour. So that's awesome. It's good to know that OneForma is very competitive with DAT in the large language model project work. So I'm hoping to get this project long-term. I want to keep everyone updated to see if I do pass, what my experience is like going forward and working for OneForma, because I've never got any task on the platform before. So I'm very interested to see how the payment works, how the pay structure is. Is it consistent? Or is there going to be any hassles with it? Because they did promise that these 9 qualification hits that I did do are going to get paid in full, compensated. Even if I did a crappy job, I would still get compensated. That is fully in their description of the email that they sent me. A project manager reached out to me directly and gave me instructions on how to access the link for a video. The Teams call that gave you information on how to do these hits successfully. And then they gave me another paragraph saying, please do these 10 hits on this one date and we will compensate you regardless of your performance. So far, I'm iffy on the platform's longevity in terms of this project and the functionality on how well it's serving. In terms of like how brain dead do you have to be to do this kind of work, it's a little more intuitive, I would say, than DAT. You don't have to be as creative, which is better for me personally as a black and white financial analyst accountant person. I don't really have a super creative gene in me. So this is a little more technical, but I wouldn't call it like technical knowledge. I would just say it's more precision and labeling of words and making sure that everything lines up and the search results are better. That's all I can say. Hopefully I can get past this initial starter of the 10 hits and work on this long term. This is supposed to be a longer term project. You're supposed to work on this like 5 hours a day. So if I do get past this test, I'm going to be extremely busy before and after my day job. But that's what I'm here for, right? I just want to sacrifice, put myself out there on these websites, earn as much as I can, and give my feedback, my honest feedback, to all of you out there who support my channel. Speaking of which, thank you so much for getting me to 20,000 subscribers, making my dream have a chance at reality of retiring early. So hope you enjoyed this video. I'll keep everyone updated on OneForma, on whether or not I get past a grading assessment and what my experience is in terms of getting paid, any issues there, and contact with project managers and so on. So hope you enjoyed this video. It's Road to Retire. See everyone in the next one.